Roger.
This is Pequot. Arriving shortly at LZ.
Whatever supplies you need, just let us know.
This is Pequot. On station at LZ.
The Soviets have indicated they are not participating in the Los Angeles Olympics, primarily because the United States has made no attempt to guarantee the safety of the Soviet Union's athletes. The United States is increasingly demonstrating the belief that the issue has nothing to do with its preparations, and in fact this is retaliation for the Western nation's boycott of the previous Moscow Olympics. That concludes today's news.
That's quite some news. The Soviet Union not attending the LA Olympics? Yeah. Andropov's death has changed some things. They're calling it revenge for the Western boycott of the Moscow Olympics.
Countries boycotted the Moscow Olympics?
Yes. In protest of the Soviet Union's invasion of Afghanistan, over 50 countries were absent. It's too bad I didn't get to see Yamashita's judo. When the 40th Army crossed the Amu River 4 years ago, detente went right out the window. The U.S. Congress chose not to ratify SALT II. And Reagan's hardline politics won him the presidency in a landslide. According to him, the Soviet Union's an evil empire.
The second Cold War.
And there's been no end to regional conflicts and civil wars. Lebanon, the Falklands, Grenada, Iran, Iraq. The story never changes.
Egypt and Israel did sign a peace treaty. But then the driving force on the Egyptian side, President Sadat, was assassinated afterward. Apparently, his actions were considered a betrayal of his fellow Arabs.
Islamic extremists?
Yes. Fundamentalist extremists have been responsible for some bold acts of terrorism in recent years.
We've had extremist students in Iran take U.S. embassy workers hostage, and suicide bombings in Lebanon. Over 300 foreign soldiers stationed there have been killed.
Countries have yet to develop an effective means of dealing with terrorism. Afraid of losing their own men, they've pulled their forces out, handing private forces a golden opportunity.
Private forces?
Small armies with no national affiliation, working for the highest bidder. That's right, they got the idea from you. After Mother Base went down, they began spreading to meet the soaring demand. Miller's organization is just one of many PFs now. The entire world is after you. But at the same time, it needs you too. Miller told me about what happened in the Caribbean 9 years ago.
Thank you.
destroy that, but turn it off to shut off all the lights and surveillance cameras in the outpost. But of course, the enemy will realize something's up. If you're gonna do it, be quick. Sheep around. With the local residents gone, they've gone back to the wild. The security forces must know something about the targets. After you grab or hold up an enemy, try interrogating them.
Where are your friends?
Soviet soldier. A lot of them came from Central Asia before, but lately they've been using more and more Russians. Simple, really. There's less hesitation to pull the trigger if they're not fighting their own race. Morbid cynicism, but it gets results. That's humanity for you. Extraction. If you have to extract someone who's on the verge of death, you better use the chopper. But if you're gonna carry them, put them to sleep first. You won't get far if you have to fight them every step.
Where are the others? Speak.
Just what we need to develop new weapons and equipment. Roger.
Arriving shortly at LZ.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Thanks for that, boss.
Where are your friends?
Boss, we don't have enough medicinal plants. Thank you, boss.
Roger.
This is Pequot. Arriving shortly at LZ.
Miller told me about what happened in the Caribbean 9 years ago. You do remember Miller. You'd formed a private army with him, an army with no allegiance to a nation.
I remember, but...
I see. You're not sure what's fact and what's a fantasy caused by the coma. It's still all a mess, huh? All I can do is tell you the facts as they were told to me. I've gone easy on you up until now, but this is where the hard stuff begins. 1974, the year before you entered your coma. You were in Colombia, operating with a small unit of men, basically mercenaries. Miller was among them. Miller was trying to find a way to turn his and your talents into a line of work. He was looking to start a business where you would fight on behalf of others around the world, those who needed military force. But the reality was, at that time, you didn't have enough gear to equip your own men. Then Miller came across this client. There's a huge job he was offering, but you had a shot at pulling it off. You accepted it and headed into Costa Rica. The client even threw in an offshore facility in the Caribbean. The mother base that would be your new base of operations. Miller sure did have a head for business. As your mission went on, your unit grew and grew. More weapons, more money. Before you knew it, you were commanding 300 men. As the organization got bigger, your military power swelled to match. It got so the international community couldn't afford to ignore you. You were just too damn successful for your own good.
You, your men, had worn out your welcome. Everyone was out for you. East, West, First World, Third. It was only a matter of time before someone took you down. And that was XOF. Officially, they're an anti-terror unit under the CIA. In reality, they're Cypher's private strike force. They lured you to Cuba using Chico, the Nicaraguan revolutionary kid, and Paz, a mole who worked for Cypher as bait. While you were gone, XOF, posing as a nuclear inspection team, stormed Mother Base. At the same time, C4 they placed on the strut legs went off. The whole thing went down in minutes. XOF. Kisses and hugs followed by a big F-U. All because of Miller's blind spot. A back door into Mother Base no one suspected. You remember a certain scientist. Huey was responsible for bringing the inspection team on board, giving the enemy a perfect opportunity to hit you at home. You were returning from Cuba when it happened. Mother Base came damn close to taking you with it into the Caribbean. Those of your men out on assignment returned right away. They refused to believe the wreckage in the water they found was Mother Base. But they checked the coordinates again and again until reality finally settled in. You were supposed to die that day. That was XOF's primary objective. As far as most folks know, you did. The first doctor to see you wasn't even sure what he was looking at. Before they'd even finished operating, your men moved you to that hospital in Cyprus. There was a woman named Eva who arranged that. Rings a bell, hmm? Most men in your condition would have been written off right from the start. But you survived. You went straight down to hell, and they pulled you out. Your eye wide open. Full of venom. The days of Naked Snake are long gone. Welcome back, Venom Snake. This world still needs you.
faster to the domestic carrot. It's also a favorite of wild animals.
Помни, что у парня, который уехал с отводом пополнения?
Иван Иванович Иванов. Тихий, малый. Небось, какой-нибудь фанат фантастики?
Он оставил книгу, английскую новеллу под названием 1984.
Что, она выпущена в этом году?
Нет, мы написали лет 30 назад.
А о чем она?
Я не смог прочитать ее, она на английском. Но речь идет об утопии, когда весь мир стал коммунистическим.
Ого, правда?
Автор англичанин, так что я не думаю, что мы герои. Скорее всего, мне будет написано, что коммунизм — это зло. Может, он решил, что капиталистический мир по умолчанию лучше.
Не то чтобы единый коммунист, но это...
Ладно, мне пора.
Удачи.
Sight of you. They're gonna try to hunt you down.
Yeah. Понял. Проверьте окрестности. Конец связи.
Это Зоя-2! Слышу стрельбу! Направление определено! Что разрешено?
Roger. Roger that.
Snake, try this on.
A prosthetic arm.
Yeah, Miller was calling it the arm that wasn't there. The physiotherapy's going well. Your arm's bulked up enough for it to fit. There. Perfect. A little time with it, and it'll work better than the real thing. What do you think?
Huh. I can still feel my real arm.
Well, you better get used to this one quick. You have any pain?
Every now and then.
Where?
My fingertips. My left fingertips.
Sounds like phantom pain. Your brain still remembers your old hand.
Yeah.
What about your vision? Can you see okay?
Yeah, at the moment.
Now, the shrapnel in your skull is pressing on your optic nerve. I'm told any hard impact could have an effect on your visual cortex.
Yeah. The doctor mentioned that.
Your brain might process visual information incorrectly. In other words, you could have hallucinations. You might see things that aren't there, or not see things as they really are. You experience any of that?
I think so.
When?
Right after I wake up. Colors look faded.
Colors, huh? Well, that's not a major concern in and of itself, but it could mean the difference between life and death in the field. You'll need to watch out for that.
I will.
All right. You should continue your physio. We'll be arriving soon. It's the last chance you'll get.
Welcome back, boss.
Thanks for that, boss.
Thanks for letting me join the fight. I'll do whatever you ask.
Morning, boss. We need more medicinal.
Boss, thanks for saving that cute little puppy.
Whatever supplies you need, just let us know, boss.
Thank you.